Hello children, in the previous video we learned about equivalent fractions. In this video we will see some interesting examples of this. Today Babban, Golu and Chanda have come to buy clothes from Barbole uncle's shop. Babban bought an 18 meter cloth of this design. Golu bought an 18 meter cloth of this design. And Chanda bought an 18 meter cloth of this design. When Babban reached his house, he thought, why not give 1/3 of his cloth to Golu and take a piece of the same length of cloth from him? In this way, they will have two different designs of cloth. Children, can you tell how Babban can make 1/3 of his cloth and how long will it be? If you wish to, you can stop the video and find the answer. Absolutely right! In this way, Babban will cut his cloth into 3 equal parts and take 1 part from it, and that would be 1/3 of the cloth. If we divide 18 meters into 3 equal parts, each part will be 6 meters long. If you wish to, you may see. This first part is 6 meters. The second part is also 6 meters. And this third part is also 6 meters. 6 meters plus 6 meters plus 6 meters equal to 18 meters. In this way, this 1/3 part of Babban's cloth will be 6 meters long. Babban took 1/3 of his cloth and reached Golu's house. He told Golu his idea and Golu agreed. But there was one problem. Golu had already cut his cloth into 6 equal parts. Can you tell how Golu will be able to give Babban a cloth as long as his cloth? Let's see. Golu placed parts of his cloth like this and placed Babban's cloth's part just above it. Now he sees that 2 parts of his cloth are equal to 1 part of Babban's cloth. Do you think the same? This means 1/3 part of Babban's cloth and 2/6 part of Golu's cloth are equal. Let's look at it in another way. We saw in the beginning of the video that 1/3 part of Babban's cloth is 6 meters long. The length of Golu's cloth is also 18 meters. And he has made 6 equal parts of his cloth. So, how many meters will the length of one part be? Or how many meters will be 1/6 of 18 meters? 3 meters. But Golu has given 2/6 part to Babban. That is 2 parts out of 6. In this way, Golu has given Babban 2 times 3 or 6 meters long cloth. So you see children, Golu has given Babban equal length of cloth. Here the lengths of Babban and Golu's cloths are the same. And 1/3 of Babban's cloth is equal to 2/6 of Golu's cloth. Therefore, these fractions are equivalent fractions. Babban took Golu's cloth and went to his house. While going home, he thought, why not replace one third of his cloth with equal piece of Chanda's cloth? In this way, he will have three designs of cloths. On thinking this, he immediately took one third of his cloth and reached Chanda's house. He told Chanda his idea too, and Chanda also immediately agreed. But Chanda had cut her cloth into 9 equal parts. Now, how will Chanda be able to give Babban a cloth as long as the part of his cloth? Chanda, just like Golu, placed parts of her cloth like this and placed Babban's cloth's part just above it. Now she sees that three parts of her cloth are equal to one part of Babban's cloth. Children, is Babban's thinking correct? Are one third part of Babban's cloth and 3/9 part of Chanda's cloth equal? Let us now look at it in another way. We know that one third of Babban's cloth is 6 meters. The length of Chanda's cloth is also 18 meters, and she has made 9 equal parts of her cloth. So, how many meters will the length of one part be? Or how many meters will 1/9 part of 18 meters be? 2 meters. But Chanda has given Babban 3/9 part, or 3 parts out of 9. In this way, Chanda has given Babban 3 times 2, or 6 meters long cloth. Therefore, 3/9 of Chanda's cloth is equal to 1/3 of Babban's cloth. And these two are also equivalent fractions. In this way, 1/3 is equal to 2/6 is equal to 3/9. All these are equivalent fractions. Babban took 3/9 part of Chanda's cloth from her and happily returned home.